What is up, good people? Today we're going to just go over showing you how to sharpen in Photoshop, or show you how to just tweak things in Lightroom and how to handle them better. So today's all going to be about sharpening, and welcome back to Simple Sundays. What is up, everybody? So as I said before, we're going to do sharpening and how it works. So I'm going to do most of it on my computer, but I just want to do an intro and talk to you about it. So sharpening your photos, especially in Lightroom, is very important, because when you do a raw photo, it does add its own sharpening, but it's always different on different cameras. So when you go down to sharpening, I'll show you where to do it. There's a few sliders you can move around. Some of them affect it differently. So I'm going to show you how to do that, then export with sharpening. And I'll show you how to add some sharpening to a layer on Photoshop, which also helps when your photo was a little bit out of focus, but also it just cleans things up a little bit. You can add sharpening to certain spots. So we're gonna jump straight over to the computer. I'm gonna show you how to do it over there. All right, so we are on the computer now. I'm gonna show you what to do in Lightroom first. So when you come into Lightroom, when you go to this detail tab here, you'll see there's a few sharpening things. These are usually done automatically by Lightroom, and usually you can just leave them. But if you wanna get a little bit more intricate with it, you can go to each one of these. They all do different things, and the easy way to see what it's doing is hold Alt while you click on it. So if you move it normally, nothing happens, but if you hold Alt, it'll go black and white, and you can see better what's going on. So that's going to sharpen everything. That's the overall sharpening. Then the middle one is going to make lines look a bit thicker. So if you want to get very subtle detail, you pull it all the way down, or just, I usually have it about there. If your photo is a little bit out of focus, you can actually pull this up, and it will try and sharpen bits that are not really in focus. I don't know if it'll work over there. So if you look at that stuff over there, if you pull this up, it's going to try and put edges on it, which you don't really want. You kind of want, but if you have a little bit of motion blur or a little bit of out of focus on your image, this actually can save it a little bit. And then this one is all the like little points on her face. So if you move this one, you'll see the little lines on her face get a bit harsher. So you don't have to move it too much. I would just, it just shows you how to do this. And then masking, as you move this, it will only sharpen the part that's white. So if you leave it there, it's sharpening the whole image. If you pull it down, you can see that now it's only sharpening most of her eyes. It's not doing her skin too much. And if you go here, it's doing a bit more of her skin. So you force it to not sharpen the background. So right now, if you look at the background, there's black everywhere. And as I pull it back, it's sharpening everything, right? So if you can mask it, even to there is a good idea, or over there. It chooses which details to sharpen. Okay, so that's what you do in Lightroom. So when you export, go down here to sharpening, output sharpening, click screen and click standard. Don't go high, just go standard. And then this is usually for printing. So if you're gonna print on matte paper, do it like this. But for me, I in general just do screen and I do standard and I export. And then the rest gets done in Photoshop. Jumping into Photoshop, this is the best method I like to use to sharpen. There are sharpening tools, and there's sharpening filters over here. Sharpen thing filters. It does work. The way I like to do it, let's zoom into her here. The way I like to do it is you duplicate the layer, you go filter, you go other, you go high pass, okay? And then if you look at her, you can see detail there. But what you want to do is move the slider around till you like the extra detail it adds. Okay, if you go too far, things will start glowing. So the moment you start seeing color blur like this, you can stop. So I normally go about 1, 1.2, or just a bit less, and then you go okay, and then you change this layer blending mode to linear light. Then what you can see here is, if we turn this off and on, you can see how much sharper it is. Okay, and then what you can do is just drop the opacity down a bit so it's not too harsh. And then the best part is you Alt click on the mask, and then what you're going to do is just take a paintbrush with a white paintbrush, and then paint on the areas you want sharpening to happen. So like this, you can see that now it's only affecting those little areas. So that's my way of sharpening in Photoshop. Yeah, and then the Lightroom tips before. Anyway, let's finish this off. Okay, a big thank you for watching. Thank you for always coming back on a Sunday to check these out. I'm trying to be more helpful, so please let me know what I can help you with in the future. I've got a cool one for next week. Thanks again for coming. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please check out the links below. You can support the channel through all those links that's down there. Please remember to like, subscribe, click the bell, leave us a comment, create some conversation downstairs. I know a lot of people are replying to each other, which is great. And I'll reply to everybody if I can. And yeah, I'm really enjoying doing this so much with you guys. And if you've got any specifics you want me to cover, just let me know in the comments below. Anyway, my name is Robert Harris, and I'll see you later. Hello? Hello?
What's up?
If you guys have anything you want me to test or do or try or do, I said do it twice. Some good lighting I did, yeah.
Yeah, Rob could be like, hey, Michelle's not sick anymore.